Yeah, and I fixed my Skyrim setup, so it's only 398 mods on that one. That's another collection. Okay, let's check it out. Horace Green with dying is part of the friendly spot to adapt his caution and strategize to survive. Fame intense nightmare, but ready for him for giving account an extreme caution in a true horror test. Experience the chilling atmosphere without the constant stress of deaths. Enjoy the horror, die less, and explore at your own pace. For unforgiving encounter, extreme caution in a true horror test. Yeah, let's try it out. Vibration I can turn off. It's not hooked in anyway. Since it's our first playthrough. To start this war, you need two things. First, a basic set of skills. Second, the good goddamn sense to do whatever is necessary. I teach you the first. Second is up to you. Remain Delphi, General of the Brigade, 4th Army of the Third Republic. Three bullets. Back there. Okay. Hey Capitol, yeah, I mean, done with that one. How are you doing, Capitol? Yeah, now I've installed the Skyrim and modded it. If you have the run, you can use a craft and pick up another copy and press tab to access the inventory page and find the two copies to run. Granada. I think the one that you use, you need to open the door. Hmm. What else do you usually play in Capital? Ghost hit? Hit one. We have four. Oh shit. Oh, I should have ran. That was
get this on fast, fast. We'll dine on the yacht. We'll make it out of this hell together. Follow me. We're nearly there.
That was supposed to happen.
Beat that roll, my friend.
Fate's a bastard. I'm on patrol tonight, then. C'est la vie.
Down the hole. Quite seem like he's still alive.
I'll get you back to safety. Just hold on to me.
a mine or a grenade. You are now on your own. Learn, adapt, experiment, and survive. Yeah. Heel pressing, huh? All notes that you pick up can be found under the notes tab of your inventory. If you directly to the picked up note, press the tab or the icon slash. 10th July 1916. Solid Clement admitted to medical treatment following events of 9th July. Personal effects held in the storage locker. Patient remains in weak coma state, will respond to stimuli, but only for a brief periods of time. When last roused, he reported no memory of recent events, had trouble recalling even his own name, most likely due to severity of initial head trauma. We'll continue to monitor. If status does not improve in a week's time, recommend transfer to Santiago for neurological tests. Signed, Dr. Kosinski. Thank you. flashlight.
July, 1700 hours. I'm in a state of agony. It cripples my body, captures my mind, bleeds my soul. This thing I've done, this thing. It is lunch in the mess hall currently. Oh, the thought of eating repulses me.
Autopsy of Reynard, 14 July 1916, body of Sergeant Reynard. Multiple lacerations, chest cavity torn to shreds, every rib crack. Skull cracked open by repeated blunt force trauma. Could have done this to him.
You. want to escape, you need to blow it back open. There's dynamite in the arsenal. Ah, and a handle to trigger it somewhere in the excavation site. Get them, and you can make it out. That thing, it's coming for me. Here, take this. Finish me off, please. I want to die at the hands of a Border soldier, not that monster. There's ammo in the pantry. Get it. Do the job, please. It's coming. Quickly now.
Of course, as curious we are, we have to go and look. Words. Good. Wait, hmm. work. Rats and burned corpses. Update to the old medical and mortuary personnel. The rat problem has not gotten any better. They're swarming every dead body. They're even coming after the wounded, but the vermin have no interest in flesh after it is burned. The new policy must be instituted. The bodies of all deceased soldiers must be burned. I've spoken to Father DeRay about this matter. He'll provide proper consecration for the deceased. Remains will be preserved for families. This is not ideal, and it fills my soul with pain, but burning the dead seems to be the only way to stop the rats from coming, so burn them we must. That sucks. Bunker will be updated with objectives and details as you progress. Guess we need to go to the generator and get the lights going, right? And it needs probably fuel. Produce by lighting this lamp. The Batista. Clerk regarding dog tags. Important. When processing deceased soldiers, please check the reverse side of their ID tags for any messages, symbols, or log reports. These should be wiped clean before the tag is preserved and recorded. Kiyofri Law, head clerk. That one didn't have anything. both. I generate by filling it with fuel and pulling the lever. Keep the light on. The beast hunts in the dark. The light is our only chance and generates our only hope. It must be kept fueled at all times, day and night. The continuous rotation of two runs to the main fuel supply must be maintained. Watch each other's backs, keep each other safe, and not let the light go out for all our sakes. I'm just wondering if you can... Fuel and firing. Generally, the fuel is extremely flammable. Do not light any fires near the fuel. Do not fire any weapons near the fuel. For God's sake, do not even smoke your cigarettes near it. Store it only in sturdy metal canisters. Glass breaks far too easily. If it spills, wipe the air clean immediately when disposed of the rags outside the bunker. Thank you. Okay. Okay, so we have to get the dynamite and if we go out here, we need to go down to the left. Question if we can go past all the way. And we also have maintenance over there. What we came from was a sick room. We checked the medical stores and doctor's office. Couldn't go around here, so we couldn't get in here. We need to go out here, down, if we can go through here or not. Let's go over here, see if we can get into maintenance. That's what we need to do. Don't think there's any other. I think that's what we need to do, right? How to get the hell out of here. I've not seen another human for hours now. I might be the last, but in the hope that there might be another, I'll leave this now so you don't waste any time. This is the only exit, the only way out of this hell of our own making. It was blown closed, it needs to be blown open. Don't bother digging, impossible. Blow it up. And Dynamite is locked in the arsenal. Okay. We can get to the arsenal first. Arsenal. Dynamite. Maybe I should use the new steam. Oh no. I'm playing steam. Arsenal. Okay. Detonator handle is where? Roman tiles. Okay. Just finally go back to a bit of marking your maps and notes, it's certainly gonna be highlighted in notes. Yeah, so we need to go down there, yeah. Lockdown. How the heck did we unlock that then? Explosive. Tibet's journal, strange sounds. 14 July 1916, night. Strange scratching sounds a few moments ago. No, it sounds like someone is pacing the hallway. Probably Reynard drunk from the stash of wine I know he hides from us. Best to confront him now. Either get him into bed to sleep it off or convince him to share a bottle or two with me. 15 July 1916. All fear runs through all our veins now. Cornier has terrorized the men for answers. Say they are asleep until Reynard screams. Believe him, of course. Cornier went so far as to accuse prisoner 73014 of escaping his cell and committing the murder. Impossible. I worry about Fournier. His rage hides fear. He takes it out on the men and I can see no way to stop it. Reads contempt. My mind slips back to the moment Reynard started screaming. How easily it could have been me. How easily it still could be. For the first time I wish the order to attack would come. I would rather face a thousand German guns than this nameless dread. Let's find a journal. To any who find this, Fournier, our commanding officer, cowers next to me now. He's lost his mind to an abyss of fear. repeats the same refrain over and over. Flee, flee, we must flee and seal the beast where it belongs. He wants to run, to blow up the exit behind him, sealing the demon down here, the demon and our men. His constant refrain, it is getting to me, and that same void of terror, it is also overtaking me. Any of my men who see this, once we are free of this place, I will get the arson code from him. I will get it and I will radio it back to you. Trapped trapped down here with that beast, the arsenal may be our only hope. It's all I can do, all I have courage to do. Get the communications, get to the communications room in the soldiers' quarters, hide there. I'll broadcast the code to you. Yes, we need to get to the soldiers. Stuff I want to bring with me. Yes, we need to go down there past me. Well, ain't that typical, huh? the one that we need.
Of July. I do not know the time, but dusk has fallen and still, of course, no word. When I asked the sergeant, he shrugged, as if I was asking about when it might next rain. These fools around me, laughing, drinking, arguing. Do they know what I've done? Do they suspect it? I feel they must all be guilty of something. And yet, they laugh, drink, argue. God knows what I've done. I wonder if his judgment could be worse than my own.
Yes, we need to find the line. I wonder if any information could be in have any map. There it is. Doesn't come up the name, it's just circle, but it's barely noticeable. Okay, so it's past there where we found Jobert's. It's all the way in the end there. I'm gonna test something. I'm just curious how this might work. They found us? How? I didn't even see him there. I just heard a noise and then all of a sudden... It's weird. Let's just see how the tests. I'm kind of curious to see how he Dude, it's too hot for me to sit and play with a camera. I'm sitting here, shirtless, have a fan on me. Don't wanna scare people with my white ass chest. Okay, so we got around there. I could bring a grenade. So we're gonna try it. Suicidal way. Why is that rock gone? Head there. I mean, I could have the lights on and stuff, but I kind of want to see if we can do it in this one. Thank you. kind of curious to know if how the monster comes and if there's a way to hide from it, or you stand still, or does it know exactly where you are. Easiest they would just bring the grenade, you know, and toss it, but... Broke the door. I think you're able, you should be able to do this in the dark. Plus, if you just walk along the walls, you see everything, so. But you don't really need a flashlight. Walk like this, you see the wall and you see the stairs. The question is just where the monster is. I'm gonna be unlucky like I was last time when we opened the door and then the monster was right there. It's like, okay. I think it's because I had the flashlight on. God damn it, I forgot to put away my grenades. Oh, 589. And stuff that you need to, that's important, they are highlighted, so. La Rose Report. Clora, do you know what? You can do the shirtless. You're the one who's getting the beach body. I'm getting the bum body. 15 May 1916 from Sidi La Rue, U.M. Fournier and D. Blanchin. I'm not putting into writing what I have reported to both of my immediate superiors. Last evening, 14th May, I was assigned to aid engineers in mapping the Roman tunnels. I can put up a pole for you too, so you can dance with it. As I entered the deepest area of the tunnels, I noticed strange glowing liquid seeping from the walls. When I turned around, the walls of the tunnels themselves were suddenly gone, and I was standing in a vast plain of darkness. In the distance, there was a sickly light that seemed to be calling me forward. Between it and me, malformed shadows moved. I blinked again. It was gone. I was back in the tunnel. It lasted but a split second, but I am quite convinced that what I saw was no daydream. It was real. In that experience, I have felt haunted, like a part of me is still there, stuck in the tunnels. I keep seeing shapes moving at the edges of my vision. I am formally requesting medical leave. Please help me. this way. We go through this main room. Do a save and then we go to the... I'm gonna put away all the grenades I have on me. Might bring one with me. To the using storage. We can get the crank and open this one so we can get into the soldiers' quarters. Where's my invisibility spell that we had in Oblivion? It's dark in the storage room. Okay, so what's it? 0589. He do wander around then. Okay, so we do it this way. Thank you. Wonder if you can use a flashlight on him and he will recoil, by the way. I think about that when they said that he hates light. I wonder if a flashlight is enough.
Thank you.
Clem.
9th of July, night. My conscience compels me now, as it failed to compel me then. I must do something, even if it costs me my own life. I must do something lest I never sleep again. I must do something or risk greeting hell itself as a relief. I must do something. I go.
Get under. Couldn't get under because of these things. Crap was in the way. I have to wait one more round here. How are you doing? Here in Paranoia, Fournier claims one of us killed Raynor, but I saw Raynor's corpse, his eyes were gone. Gouged from his skull, his tongue was shredded. We all hated Raynor, but none of us could have done this. War is brutality, but it is anonymous. Mechanized, we fired distant soldiers, whoever did this, it was intimate, it was sadistic, a fear for all of us. Hello, Murphys. How are you doing? You and your naps, man. Let's see what we got here. Medkit, then we have bandage. Got a flare. Clement, 5200. I have one more thing on. I'm curious though about this monster. Say he hates life. So what about the flashlight then? guess he doesn't care about that one. See if we can test it. Sure, Memphis. Oui. Thirty-three.
July 8th, mid-afternoon. Joubert needs a scout for tonight. Routine patrol. Out to the communication wires and back. It'll be cloudy. Good cover. Easiest patrol possible. Sergeant wants me or Augustin to go. He still suspects one of us might have been with the mutineers. But I won't be going. How can I be so sure? Well, Augustin has agreed to a friendly game of chance to determine which of us it will be. And using an old sleight of hand trick, there's no way I'll lose. No. Augustin doesn't have a chance, because I'll ensure he doesn't. Me? A scoundrel? Perhaps. But when he returns and I remind him of the time he pissed in my flask, or the mysterious lice that appeared in my bunk, or the incident with that barmaid. Well, I laughed in those cases, and he'll laugh in this one. 8th of July, near midnight. Shelling again somewhere along the line. Them firing at us. I'm sure we will fire at them again soon. I hope Augustin is having a simply marvelous time out there. Can't wait to tell him what I did. 9th of July, time unknown. It must be just before dawn. When the shelling stopped, I woke. The sudden silence always does that. Augustin's bunk is empty. I went looking for him. He wasn't in the mess, nor being seen by Dr. Jasinski, nor lurking out for a final smoke. Dax was on patrol. I asked him. He said Augustin hasn't returned from the scout. He said the words like he was pronouncing Augustin's death. As if scouts don't come running back at all hours. As if it wasn't just a routine patrol. As if all hope was lost. Now the shelling is starting again. We'll try to sleep. 9th of July, morning. It has been hours now and Augustin has not returned. His luck did not hold, and neither has mine. What could I have been thinking? If he is gone forever. But I do not want to write it for fear writing it will make it real. I will continue to wait in my bunk until dusk. And if there is no sign of him, then I do not know. The priest keeps staring at me, as if he can sense I have some unseen weight on me. I will not give him the satisfaction of a confession. It was nothing. A joke. I thought it was just a joke. I never thought. And therein lies my sin.
I'm gonna go in the communications room then. thing is, when you're using the light, you should probably one should just, you know, run. Let me get some more coffee. Just gonna refill my coffee cup. Let me move on. Be right back. Scare people, Colorian. Meanie. Okay, let's see if we can. He's coming at us. I'm curious about the flashlight. They say the monster hates light. And he hates the flashlight then? Attention, a power in this part of the facility is the daisy chain. Cut off the power in one section and the chain, the subsequent areas will go off as well. Which should only be turned off under extraordinary circumstances, like when I say so. Thanks, the mission will be reported directly to Reyna. This one. So we need to find a key. Go. Barbara dies. Barbara is gone. Insanity. Chaos. He was in the mess and he burst from the shadows right behind the boys' room. But Barbara was there, ready. Practically threw himself in front of the thing. He shot it. Hit it. Dead on. The thing retreated. Before for sure he was dead. But then, 10 minutes later, he came back for him. I heard him screaming, being pulled into the wall, praying for salvation. Now I can hear it moving again, getting closer. This Muna will all suffer his fate. To Farber, I was there when they pulled your friend Neuer from the tunnels. He'd been screaming for hours before he was located, tied to the stretcher. He was still trying to scream, but all that came up was a horrible rasp. All of the engineers have seen things down there, myself included. We should talk, you and I, about what is to be done. Let me know when. Who's that? Who's that? Blow it up, but I think we will be get blown up too then. There was a concrete block in one of the lockers. more, I probably can shoot it open. But question is what the monster will do. Journal Part 2. 14th May 1916. I have spoken to no one of what's written in those texts, I swear it. But now LaRue comes out of the tunnels claiming to have seen things described in them. My rational mind cannot accept that this might be a coincidence, nor can it accept the alternative. I have to tell the others what's written in these texts. Tell them. Warn them. 18 May 1916. They have punished LaRue for speaking out about what he saw and no Raynor has sent for me. I'm sure I am to be punished as well. We are stuck between the Germans in front of us, High Command behind us, and some other horrible force that seems to lurk in shadows all around us. I fear we are now truly beyond God's reach. 20th May 1916. I've been locked in Delphi's cells for the past 2 nights, Raynor's punishment for me speaking about the text. Nightmare after nightmare there, dreams of darkness, seductive darkness, voices there welcoming me. I returned to my bunk and was met with the men, all of whom now have tales to tell. Nikolai, Farber, Ulebeck, on and on. They're all hearing things, dreaming things. Nights are now spent in the grip of fear that crawls up on the spine and digs its claws behind the eyes, piercing mind and soul. But after what happened to LaRue and me, no one dares speak to the officers, not even to Joubert. Worse, raids are beginning again. I'm to go tomorrow night. 23 May 1916. Back from the raid. Can't sleep. Shells falling, the soles of my boots are worn thin, my feet bloody and blistered. Lost too many out there. I feel trapped. 25th of May 1916. Last night the entire barracks was awakened by the sounds from the tunnel. Nightly they grew louder. When I slept I dreamt of other worlds, of pain wrapped in ecstasy. This morning we are all as ghosts. Things cannot continue this way. I will enter the tunnels and see if I can find some way to end this for all our sakes. Hello, Chronolus and gang. Thanks for the raid. Hope you all are doing well. I'm hiding from a monster too. Doing okay. No, please, nothing here. Oh, I didn't have time to shoot. I need to just get the heck out of there after I read that note. God damn it. I got killed. Well, I'm doing it a little bit harder to myself than it should be to them. You can turn on the light, but you need fuel for it to last, so... I mean, we could use that one to attract him, I guess. We need to get some dynamite and blow up the exit to get out of here. problem is the dynamite is somewhere in the soldiers' quarters in the communication, they say, but that doesn't seem to be correct. And we can't get to the arsenal yet because it's locked. And I don't know how to unlock it yet. We're going down to the soldiers' area and trying to figure out things. And this is the only place you can save. And this is the only light you have. If you don't use the burn the fuel in the generator. But finding fuel is not that easy either, so... I didn't expect the monster to actually open that door where we were hiding in. The monster can open certain doors. Well, he smashes through them, I should say. And he's attracted to noise. Don't get this. Why is it to the right? There, I have to pull it. He's in the room to the left right now. Is the key that we need. It's kind of hard to know where he is right now. actually hide under here. Didn't think about that one. And there's an exit here he can come out at, so this big dude can somehow crawl through these little tiny tunnels. Here's an empty bottle. Let me have fuel. Can I put in fuel here? That wouldn't surprise me if you can put a rag on it too. Make a Molotov. Padlock on it, so there's two ways, well, three ways we can do this. We can move that one over there and blow it up. We are shoot it. Don't have a rock, one of these concrete blocks here, so I can't break it open. I can use a grenade. But we're gonna do it in a noisy way. And we're gonna hide under the table. See if it comes out soon. Kind of curious to see how it looks like. Huh? What didn't he pop up there for now? Like he did last time. Like, makes no sense. So I have to have the power on so I can hear the code. The thing is, you can't save now either, so it's like... We have to go back to that save room, plus we need to turn on the power. Close call. Okay, so it's gonna do this. That one away. The thing is, you only have a finish is yesterday, Ali. This is Amnesia, the bunker. Totally different game. Plays out in World War One. Okay, there is something else here. Okay, so what we need to do is we need to activate that one. April 1960, Fallon got some answer from the engineering team. Command believes there are old Roman tunnels adjacent to our position. They opened them this evening. Batman hopes to use them to launch a surprise attack. If any attack at this point could be termed surprise. This is a war. We are all always expecting an attack. Curious to see these tunnels, though. A little dash of antiquity would live in the place up, but certainly help keep my mind off the daily grind of the war. And 9th of May, 1916. The officers presented me today with a rather unexpected and strange gift. Aging text from inside a Roman tunnel. Seems to got word of my interest. I took them, of course, but the truth is these texts are far too fragile, too valuable to survive life in this horrible place, or horrid place. They require more delicate hands, more learned minds than mine. Still, curiosity rings. 11th of May, 1916. This morning, Aikman died of his wounds. I had only known him at a time, but consider him one of my better friends here. I hope heaven welcomes him. To distract myself, I've been going over the text and have had quite a shock. These texts are not Roman in origin. The language is Latin or Latinate at least, but what they are writing about has no relation to what I know of Roman culture from any era. The text seem to be of a religious or at least superstitious nature. A phrase is repeated. We cross into the darkness beyond, and then something about sight. 13th May 1916. Haven't slept, need to get this down. The texts are of a religious nature. Whoever these ancient people were, they believed that they had found a means to immortality. And to achieve this goal, they needed access to what they thought was some other world. One dominated by darkness and ruled by, I don't know, they use words I can't translate, ruled by something. They claimed that the dark outer world was full of spirits, monsters, and that the air there was endlessly alive with cries of torment and the sickly rattle of souls near death. That is what they were using the tunnels for. Damn, it was a doorway to some pagan hell. The texts are full of wild stories of blood orgies, of sadistic spirits, of the awful things these men and women would do to each other in worship of darkness. They speak at length of some substance that is meant to grant the world is some kind of immortality in darkness. I'm on patrol tonight, need to sleep before then, but then I'm back at this. What the? Oh, come. Okay, so he doesn't care about the flashlight at all. Okay. But you can see the little tunnel right there, and he spawns like instantly out of it, seems like. Thank you. noise on. How the heck can we get what the heck? Okay, I thought I jumped over that one. Okay, I didn't think he's gonna be able to see you under. Okay. But that's not the hiding place. Well, Now we learn that.